Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the new customer acquisition goal in Google Ads. I'll also run through what it does and what you'll need to set it up. If you've logged into Google Ads over the last few weeks and looked at the conversions configured in your account, then you might have noticed something new pop up. Let's head to my demo account to take a look. We're looking at the conversions in the account, and there's a new goal or conversion action called customer acquisition at the top. If you've been running smart campaigns in Google Ads, then you might already be assigning additional value to new customers. But if you haven't been running smart shopping campaigns, this is a new feature you can use in your account. I'm going to walk you through the steps to set this up in a moment, but before I do, I'm going to run through why you should use it, who should set it up, key benefits, and what you'll need to have ready before you start setting it up. Since we are going to cover these common questions first, feel free to skip ahead using the links I've included in the description below. Okay, so why should you use the new customer acquisition goal? The customer acquisition goal lets you automatically bid more for new customers compared to existing customers. Imagine there are two people searching for your product or service. One of them has previously purchased from you, so they're an existing customer, while the other has never made a purchase. Once you've set up a customer acquisition goal, Google Ads can understand the difference between these two people and adjust your bids accordingly. For example, if the average conversion value of a customer who makes a purchase is $100, and the average lifetime conversion value of a customer is $150, then Google Ads will be able to factor this into your bids. The customer acquisition goal also allows you to only bid for new customers. This means that if someone is already a customer, then they won't see your ads. Google currently recommends you only use this option if you have a dedicated budget for acquisition, or in other words, you have a separate campaign that is just designed to acquire new customers. And they also suggest this option can be used if your campaign isn't designed to drive purchases. For example, if you're trying to generate leads or email subscribers. Who should use the new customer acquisition goal? Currently, the new customer acquisition goal can only be used with Performance Max campaigns. So if you're running a Performance Max campaign, or you're going to run a Performance Max campaign, you should set it up. If you're not running any Performance Max campaigns in your account, then at the moment there is no advantage in setting up the customer acquisition goal. Google might let us use the goal with other types of campaigns in the future, but currently it's limited to Performance Max campaigns. What are the benefits of using the new customer acquisition goal? Using the customer acquisition goal is designed to improve the performance of your campaign. Google says that it can result in a higher share of new customer conversions and can lead to lower acquisition costs. As we'll see in a moment, it's easy to set up. And if you have a way to dynamically identify new and returning customers on your website, you can also configure additional reporting. I do want to highlight that since this will impact bids, I recommend setting benchmarks for your current performance and then checking back to review the results. Automation in Google Ads does rely on data, so having enough data to feed Google's machine learning is something to consider. Okay, what do you need to set it up? To set up the customer acquisition goal, you will need to have appropriate audience lists available in your account. This means you will need existing audience lists for your existing customers. For example, if you're selling online and you've linked Google Analytics to Google Ads, then you will probably already have an audience list or segment for people who've purchased. You can then use this audience list with your customer acquisition goal. Google also highly recommends that you use a customer list when setting up your customer acquisition goal. A customer list is one where you've uploaded details for your existing customers into Google Ads. For example, you can upload a CSV that includes the email addresses of your customers into Google Ads. Or you can connect Zapier to Google Ads to automatically send details to your audience list when people make a purchase. So the most important thing you'll need to check is that you have audience lists that include your existing customers. The next step is to configure the customer acquisition goal, then apply the goal to your Performance Max campaign. Let's head to Google Ads to configure the goal. We start by navigating to Tools and Settings. and then conversions. At the top, we can see the new customer acquisition goal is available in our account. We can see that it tells us to start by setting up audience lists before creating the goal. I already have audiences configured, but if you're not sure, then you can click Go to Audience Manager to view the current lists in the account. Now let's click Setup. The first step is to select the audience list or lists that include your customers. So let's select Search. You can then search for the name of the list you want to add, or you can click Browse to view all of the lists. I'm going to click Browse. And then I'm going to select my website-based lists. And I'm going to select my customer match list. You can add up to 5 lists, and we can see the lists are added at the top. Now let's scroll down. Here we need to enter the additional value that a new customer is worth to our business. The idea is to assign a value that considers the lifetime value of your customers. For example, if you sell a product for $100 and half of your customers make a repeat purchase for the same value, then the average lifetime value of your customers would be $150. This means the additional value created by a new customer beyond their initial purchase is an average of $50. So we would enter 50 for this example. We can see that Google Ads automatically provides a suggestion for the value we could assign. Hovering over "Why this suggestion?" tells us that it's based on our existing average order value and a typical purchase frequency. So if you're not sure what to enter, you can go with Google's suggestion. I'm going to leave the suggested amount, and I'm going to click Apply. We've now set up our customer acquisition goal. The next step is to apply this to our Performance Max campaigns. So let's navigate back. Select our Performance Max campaign, and then choose Settings. Now we select Customer Acquisition, and we can enable the option that says Optimize Campaign for Acquiring New Customers. This now lets us choose Bid Higher for New Customers, or Only Bid for New Customers. We can see the value we assigned for our new customers will be used, but you can adjust this for the campaign if needed. On the right, we can also see a chart that shows the average value of an existing customer and the additional value we've assigned for a new customer based on the additional value they will add in the future. We can see there's an alert telling us we need to adjust our bidding strategy to use the customer acquisition goal. So let's click Save. And scrolling down, let's select Bidding. And then Change Bid Strategy. We can then change the bidding strategy to conversion value. And click Save. Our Performance Max campaign will now use the customer acquisition goal to automatically increase our bids for new customers. So setting up the new customer acquisition goal lets you bid higher for new customers or only bid for new customers. Currently, the feature is only available for Performance Max campaigns, but we might see this change in the future. Are you running a Performance Max campaign? Are you going to set up the new customer acquisition goal? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to see more videos about getting the most out of Google Ads, Google Analytics, and more. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.